Good morning students, this is Joy Varghese from Uncovering Chemistry. Now, today in our video number 3, we are going to discuss about anomalous behavior. Anomalous means, if you don't know the word anomalous means, unusual. What is the word? Unusual behavior. Understood? Different behavior means how do they differ from other elements. Because when we say about group 15 elements, we know about nitrogen, phosphorus, arsenic, antimony, and bismuth, right? So, rather than this four, how I this one differ in all properties that we are going to discuss. Okay, so always remember when we talk about anomalous behavior of the first element of the group, a note you can remember that first element of each group differ in properties or behavior because of smaller size and high electronegativity. High electronegativity. This is the reason what you can remember in most of the groups, what we say in general, right? Now, nitrogen shows this behavior, that is due to nitrogen shows what anomalous behavior because of small size, atomic size is small, then high electronegativity, high ionization enthalpy. Clear? High electronegativity, high ionization enthalpy, and non-availability of d orbitals. There is no d orbital in nitrogen. So these are the reason why nitrogen behaves differently from other elements of the group 15. What we say, understood? Now the second part when we say this is the point you can remember. Now the point number 3 when we say nitrogen has a unique ability to form p pi bond. Now p pi bond means what? P orbitals overlap with the another p orbitals, what we say. Multiple bond with itself means it can form p pi bond with itself and also with other elements. It can form p pi bond with itself and also with other elements to form there is a multiple bond. p pi bond means multiple bond. Now when we talk about this multiple bond, simple example, nitrogen can form multiple bond with nitrogen itself also. It can form bond with what we call it as CN, nitrocarbon also, what we say, and also with oxygen also. Right? So these are the multiple bonds it can form with what we call it as carbon, with itself, with the carbon also, and with nitrogen also. Understood this part? So remember this, heavier element below nitrogen do not form. Heavier elements means this one. They do not, don't form p pi bond. p pi bond, it does not form. Heavier element is below nitrogen, they don't form this p pi bond. Understood this part? Now, just a minute. Okay. Now, when we say nitrogen, that is N2, dinitrogen is, we can say a diatomic. Which molecule? Diatomic molecule due to, what is the reason? It is due to p pi bond, what we say. Understood? So, we can say that N2 exists as a, which molecule? N2 will be existing as a like this multiple bond, what we say in this case. This is due to triple bond between two nitrogen atoms and the bond enthalpy. What is to remember? Bond enthalpy is very high.
very high. You can see from that only, because you can see the triple bond are more shorter compared to a single bond. So that's why to break this bond, more energy is required. That's why N2 bond enthalpy is very high, what we say. Understood this part? Now lower members form. Lower members means what? This phosphorus, arsenic, antimony and all. That is lower members. Means in the below the nitrogen, what we say, the lower groups, they form a single bonds like this, what we say. Phosphorus bond is single bond, arsenic form single bond, what we say like this, and what we call antimony. And antimony also form single bonds, what we say. Understood? So lower members form single bond like that, but nitrogen forms the triple bond due to what you call it as p-pi bonding, what we have discussed already. Understood this part? Now the next part, we can say here, this is point number 4 I think. Then point number 5, that is nitrogen NN bond, that is single, when we say a single NN bond is weaker. Clear? Is weaker, what we say, then P dash P bond. Now we can say this, a single NN bond is weaker than P dash P bond, because NN bond is short. NN bond is short, what we call it as compared to, that is NN bond is short, and the two N atoms each have one, two N atom each have a lone pair on it, have a lone pair. That I think you know about nitrogen if you remember. They have what we call it as a lone pair on it, what we call it. I think you must have studied about in 11th standard. They have a lone, that is lone, you can write lone, non-bonding pair. Which pair? Lone non-bonding pair. Each atom have lone non-bonding pair, and the two lone pair repel each other. What happens? Two lone pair repel each other. This is the reason why NN bond is weak and they break very easily, because the two lone pair on nitrogen, what we say, on both nitrogen, what we have seen, they repel each other. I think we have discussed about this lone pair, bond pair, if you heard about in the lower classes, that is 11th standard we have discussed. So this is the reason what is why they are weak, what we say. Then, like carbon, nitrogen doesn't show catenation. There doesn't show catenation. Catenation. Remember this thing? I think you can watch this. Just a minute. Okay. It does not form, shows catenation like carbon, what you see now. This nitrogen doesn't show catenation. Understood this part? Now the next point. Now when we talk about point number 6, we have already discussed this 5 point, now point number 6. Due to absence of d orbital, due to absence of d orbital, we can write nitrogen can have maximum covalency of 4. I think this we have already discussed in our previous video. Okay. Then point number 7, what we said, point number 7, that is nitrogen cannot form d pi and p pi bond. Now what is the reason? Because nitrogen does not have d orbitals, what we say. So nitrogen cannot form d pi p pi bond, but heavier elements, since this we are talking about, what we say, heavier elements can form like this, that is R3P double bond O, what you see, then another one, what we can see, R3 R3P double bond CH2 like this, okay? So this I think you must have studied. Now R here, what we say R is an alkyl group. Which group? Alkyl group. Understood? So if you want to write, you can write CH3PO, what we say, or P double bond. So like this they can form what you call it as D pi and P pi bond, what we say in this case. Understood this part? Phosphorus, when we say, I think you can watch this. Phosphorus and arsenic can form d pi d pi bond. That is, both d orbitals can overlap and form the bond with the transition metals. This transition metals, we will be discussing about this in what I call it as D block elements, that is D and M block elements chapter is there, no? In that we will discuss. It can form what you call it as d pi what, because of vacant orbitals with transition metal, that is one, it is there and act as a ligand ligands, what you call it as. Now this will come in chapter number 9. That is unit 9 in your what you call it as coordination compound topic. So this topic we will be discussing at later. But in your textbook it is given, that's why we have discussed it. But this we will discuss later. Okay. So this was all about what you call it as anomalous behavior of nitrogen, what we have studied. Okay. Now the next topic what we are going to discuss is about reactivity with hydrogen. What we are going to discuss about reactivity with hydrogen. I will just rub this. So here the anomalous property and all we have discussed here, it can be asked for 2 to 3 marks. So remember this thing, okay? Next part we will be discussing in the next what we call it as topic, okay? So now the next part what we are going to discuss is about reactivity towards hydrogen. We are going to discuss about reactivity towards hydrogen. Okay? So when you talk about reactivity towards hydrogen, you can see in your textbook it is written there, that is group 15 element from hydrides, they form, that is group 15 elements, right, form hydrides of the type EH3, what we say. Now in this case when we say E, you can take it as all group 15 elements, what we have already discussed, that is nitrogen, phosphorus, arsenic, antimony and bismuth, what we say. Understood? So that hydrides when we talk about are NH3, PH3, ASH3, SBH3, what we call it as SPH3, this all are the hydride. Now bismuth is a heavier metal, so it don't form hydride like this, what we say, except bismuth. So I think this part it is clear that they form this type of hydride of EH3 type, what we call. Okay, now the next. Now in case of hydrides when we say, so we can write hydrides, we can just differentiate into four groups or four parts, that is EH bond, that is what, NNH bond, PH bond, ASH bond, SBH bond. So when we talk about EH bond becomes weaker down the group. Understood? Weaker down the group. So when we talk about the EH bond, we can say that is NH3 bond is the strongest bond. NH bond. Which bond? NH bond is the strongest. Then comes PH3. Then comes ASH3. And then comes SBH3, what we call it as, right? So in this case, the NH you can write it here. High bond dissociation enthalpy. Okay, so this NH bond is having the highest bond enthalpy, dissociation enthalpy, and this one will have the lowest bond dissociation enthalpy. Understood? So this is the hydride. Regarding hydride, what is given? Another one also, the stability order. When we say, no, I think you can watch this stability order. Stability order. Order. When we say is, when we say NH3 is more stable than PH3, more stable than ASH3, and more stable than SDH3 because of this reason what we have discussed here. Okay. Then another point, if you want to write, you can see here. I'll note this part. Okay. You can just write down this thing. AB, A and B point. You can write it down. Now the next part. When we talk about hydrides. Clear? So this was point A, B. Now we have bifurcated into point C now. C. Now when we talk about reducing power, what is the word? What? Reducing power. That is reducing either what you discussed. So reducing power will be like this. That is NH3 will be less than PH3, less than ASH3, and less than SDH. Reducing power. There is a reducing agent when you use. Thus, as the stability decreases, we can say, as the stability decreases, because stability order was greater than sign. So, as the stability decreases, reducing power increases. Understood? So, in this case, stability and reducing power are inversely proportional. Means, stability we have seen greater than arrow, and reducing power, this is more reducing, very strong reducing agent compared to NH3, what we call. Understood this part? Now, the next, that is D point, that is basicity order. Which order? Basicity order. Clear? Now, basicity order we have discussed already. So, basicity order will be same like stability, that is NH3 greater than PH3, greater than ASH3, and greater than SDH3, what we call. Understood? So, basicity order, so in this case, the basicity, you can write down, basicity of hydrides decreases down the group. Now, basicity of hydrides decreases down the group. Understood this part? So, this you can remember all these 4 points for reactivity towards hydrogen. How, what type of hydride they form? They form hydrides of EHH3. Stability we have discussed. We have discussed about what you call it as the EH bond. Why they are weaker and all. So, these all things you can remember for reactivity towards hydrogen. Okay, now in the next video, we will be discussing, that is on page number 173 in your textbook it is given, reactivity towards oxygen and reactivity towards halogen and reactivity towards metal we will be discussing in our next video. Understood? So till then we will stop this video. Okay, thank you very much. Go through this all topic, write it down in your fair books, it will be easier for you to understand. Okay, thank you very much.